The 2017 FNB Surfski Series is proudly presented by FNB. KwaZulu-Natal's sunny Durban is a surf ski paradise, famous worldwide for its golden beaches, big waves and exhilarating downwind racing conditions. The city is home to some of the world's greatest surf ski paddlers and hosts the world's biggest surf ski series, breaking world records for paddler numbers. It is the number one city in the world to live in if you are passionate about this sport. The popular 10-race series is one of the biggest of its kind globally and attracts hundreds of paddling enthusiasts to Marine Surf Lifesaving Club at Addington Beach each week for the Friday evening contests. Durban is a hotbed of paddling talent, having produced some of the best paddlers in the world in multiple disciplines for many years now, and the FNB Surfski series is the perfect platform for new talent to blood themselves in competition against the best there is. The Durban scene has been dominated over the years by two of the world's leading paddlers, Hank McGregor and Matt Bowman. The two have built up an impressive rivalry that has seen the pair trade series titles. But 2017 is a new year with new possibilities, and with new talent moving up through the ranks, this could be the year where we see a new champion. The women's series is set to be one of the most competitive yet, with the depth of women's surf ski paddling in KZN growing substantially in the recent years. Hayley Nixon, who won the Women's World Surf Ski Series title in 2016, is one of those hoping to take top honours this year. So with hundreds of excited paddlers lining Addington Beach for the first race of the 2017 FNB Surfski Series, the stage was set for an epic series opener.
Welcome down to Marine Surf Lifesaving Club for the first race of the FNB Surfski Series. We've got some of the best surfski paddlers in the world here to take part. Series favourites in the men's are definitely going to be Hank McGregor and Matthew Bowman. And in the ladies, series champion Hayley Nixon is going to be taking on Olympic bronze medalist Bridget Hartley. A little bit of rain this afternoon hasn't dampened any of the spirits of the surf ski paddlers down here to do the FNB Surf Ski Challenge. Let's go to the water for some of the action.
It's good to be back again. Best series of the year this.
Paddling's good, but at my age I can keep doing competitive things and really having fun and enjoying it.
Race one, super keen.
Super excited. Unfit, but it's going to be fun.
It's going to be exciting. Look, there are a lot of good guys out here. I think it's a good turnout for the first event. Rain's coming down. I think the spirits are still high. It's awesome.
Paddlers were greeted with overcast and rainy conditions for the first race, which is actually quite okay for surf ski paddling. We're going out in the ocean and getting wet anyway. The racing is going to be really tight with bunches, and it's going to be an awesome day out with some great surf ski action here at the FNB Surf Ski Series.
Well, a hot pace for a cold day in Durban as McGregor leads Bowman out in the men's, dominating early on, and the front two leaving the rest for dead. McGregor would prove unbeatable once more, sending out a loud and clear message here in race one. The ladies was a much closer affair. Hayley Arthur hanging on to Olympian Bridget Hartley's wake for most of the race. But Hartley too strong as she moves away in the dying moments to take her first win in her first surf ski race ever. Race 2, and it was almost deja vu. Extremely flat conditions greeted the paddlers, but this week saw record numbers on the line as 340 paddlers came out to see what the fuss was all about.
Conditions are as flat as you can get. Pretty similar to last week, race 1. Fantastic day out. I think it's record-breaking numbers today, and I think it's a lot to do with such a fantastic series that gets run by Barry and his crew.
A little bit of rain that we've had this afternoon hasn't scared off any paddlers, but it's still nice and warm and the guys are enjoying the awesome conditions out here. Today is pretty much close to a record with a great, great field.
It's fun to come down to Durban and have 200 plus paddlers in the rain and still super eager to go paddling and race each other. So the atmosphere is really amazing and it's exciting to be able to take part in an event like this.
...340 paddlers off the line in what can only be described as very honest conditions. We spoke to Bridget Hartley.
Last week I arrived with absolutely no expectation. I just jumped on the water, caught some runs and had some fun. And this week I definitely felt a bit more pressure on my head, but the conditions were slightly calmer, so I knew that it would be easier to just paddle hard.
A little bit of drizzle here and there, but it actually cooled us down out on the hot water.
I felt like I went out a bit hard in the beginning, but I think I'd already made a little bit of a gap then, so I felt like I just had to stay consistent.
And constant will be the only constant this week as Hartley and McGregor dig deep and take charge.
So today we saw some amazing numbers in the series, tons of people out on the water, and on the sharp end of the stick, Hank McGregor showed his class today with a second win in the series in absolutely sublime form. He's the World Series champion for a reason and really showed it tonight in the series.
Very happy with two wins in the bag at the moment. It's a great way to spend a Friday and start your weekend. So.
Last week's champion, Bridget Hartley, coming out on top. It's great to see class paddlers like this. Great for the sport to have that sort of caliber racing.
I started enjoying paddling in the sea, so with all the series races coming up, I guess it would be a good way to have little time trials every Friday night, as many as I can do, and I'm really enjoying them.
So, 2 from 2 for Hartley and McGregor, but still a lot of water between now and the end of the series. The FNB Surf Ski Series is a breeding ground for the best talent in paddling in South Africa. And there's quite simply no better than the current marathon world champion, Hank McGregor. We spoke to Hank about what paddling life is like in Durban and what it takes to stay at the top.
I think Durban as a paddling destination is pretty much as good as you get. You know, you can have the likes of some of the best paddlers in the world training here on a regular basis. And at the same time, at one moment it can be as flat as a lake, and the next moment it can be as huge as the biggest Molokai ever been. So for me, I think it's a great place to, you can hone your skills, and at the same time you can get down to some hard groundwork to obviously improve your paddling abilities. if you had to analyze the Durban community, it's something different every day. You know, we've got the Doozy Canoe Marathon in our backyard here in Durban. So, you know, you've got the canoeist, if you want to say it, the pure canoeist coming down to try their hand in surfski on a Friday night at the same time. One of the questions I get asked quite often is, how do you stay on the top? You know, it's always been one thing to get to the top, but it's another thing to stay on the top. And for me, you know, that's a big drive and a big motivation. Sort of defy the odds in one way is how long I can stay there and how long I can keep winning. But obviously that takes hard work. There's no shortcuts in paddling and especially in racing. You know, obviously to keep your A game on when you're arriving at big internationals with time zones, sometimes 12 hours difference, you know, you've got to put that all behind you and you've got to produce the goods on the day. And I think for me, you know, that's testing myself. And sometimes I come away with, you know, with the gold or with the win. It just makes it that much sweeter, you know, on top of it, because you know what the work you've done and how hard it's been to get there. If I had a look at what the Marine Series does for me, it actually joins all our different paddling disciplines as well as the community into one race, you know, on a Friday night. You know, it gives me a platform to work from with regards to training, and obviously sets me up for the year to come, you know. And with 10 races under your belt to become race fit, that fitness obviously carries you into the middle of the year, which is some of the biggest races in the world. But if it wasn't for the series, I wouldn't really have anything to compare myself or test myself with regards to equipment, my skills, and obviously my opposition that I'm gonna have to race against. Obviously, I enjoy the series. I mean, that's why I'm here. It's a great thing to do for me, and I'd love to win another series. But there's still races to come.
Well, what an amazing ambassador for the sport. On to the third race of the series, and this week a slightly smaller field, and an opportunity for some to make up valuable points. Moving like the speed
of sound. As we head into the Daikin Surfski Challenges Race 3, we've had two prolific winners. In the men's, Hank McGregor showed amazing form winning the first two races, but the field is wide open. Hank's away tonight, and we've got a whole lot of guys vying for really serious points in the Surfski series this season. Today is also going to see a new ladies champ with Bridget Hartley up at the Drakensberg Challenge. So the likes of Hayley Arthur, Kaita Purchase, etc. are going to be out for valuable points in the ladies division as well. The conditions are going to be user-friendly for everyone out on the water today, from a novice who's taking on his first race, all the way up to the top end of the racing field, where we've got some of the best paddlers in the world that have come down to show their mettle here at the FNB Surfski Series.
It's going to be an awesome race today. So excited. Pretty much the same condition as last time, but a little bit of wind.
Super amped, trying a new boat. The challenge is always good.
The weather is all gloomy, but it hasn't stopped anyone.
Even though the conditions have been quite similar the last 3 weeks, the wind has been challenging, blowing from a southwesterly direction, which creates little bumps out in the open ocean that surfski paddlers can catch on these fast open ocean craft. And it's going to be exciting racing at the Daikin Surfski Challenge.
So, Hayley Nixon and Matt Bowman looking to shrug off their bridesmaids' tags as they take hold of the front of the race. Valuable series points up for grabs today and some new challenges as Wade Krieger looks at the top step of the podium. Only Matt Bowman standing between him and that. No small feat. In the women's, it was Hayley Nixon in charge and looking to make some points back on Bridget Hartley.
you never know who's going to rock up, and Michelle Byrne's always got something up her sleeve, so you can't arrive complacent. There's always the opportunity of winning the series at stake, so I'm not going to just let my hair down and not think about it. I think we've all improved, and I think the field is gradually getting bigger. So now, as we've seen in this series, suddenly a supposed newcomer to surf ski comes along and we get a new winner, which means none of us can get lazy, and hopefully as South African women we'll be stronger on the international field. And that's what we all need.
Feeling was awesome today, man. It was a good race. I'm happy with my results. One guy just got me to the end, but anyway, I had a good race.
Fantastic race. Always fun to get out on Friday nights and have a jaw.
So race three would see Bowman's first win. Would this see a change in fortune for him here? Meanwhile, Nixon's good day out has turned into a victory for her too, and with three results from three, she'll take the series lead.
I'm down here every Friday, my husband comes down, and it's nice and social. We get to see all the people we paddle with on the weekends, we get our rivalry on the water. It's a good way to start the weekend.
With the series having been dominated by benign conditions in the opening 3 weeks, there was a much welcome change in race four as bigger ocean conditions were looking to level the playing fields. A backline start was called by the organisers, a good one too, as the paddlers battled the heavy surf just to get to the start line.
For the last 3 weeks we've had super flat conditions with a light southwesterly wind, and we've really got something different tonight. The northeasterly's blown the whole day. It's wrapped a little bit of swell into the Durban Bay, and we've got some surf breaking on the beach here, and we're going to have some challenging conditions for everyone for race four of the FNB Surf Ski Series. With six out of the 10 races to count, racing's going to really start to hit home now with guys after series points in the FNB Surf Ski Series.
Race four, really stoked that the conditions were a little bit different to the last couple of weeks. Surf was huge, we had a backline start, made it a little bit more interesting. And obviously the conditions were testing for a lot of people, and even for myself.
Proper surf on the backline, very consistent break. Heavy conditions going into the wind.
Hank got away as usual. He was far out in front and just a distant memory for the rest of the field. Turned the cannon. It was Wade, myself, Steve Wood.
Durban shows off with nothing less than epic downwind conditions.
On the way out there, Gene was really strong. I was just trying to hold on to his tail, and we sort of came together in the runs, going one for one there.
Unbelievable. This is what the ocean paddlers look out for. The line from the top buoy to the finish line could not have been better.
To get on the water and be doing 25 k's an hour and your paddle's sitting on your lap, it's fantastic. I mean, water coming over the nose, shark nets out the water, then under the water, and guys dodging them, getting stuck in them. And
the ladies' race was turned on its head, and we would see a clash of the titans. Previous series champ Michelle Byrne went head to head with Hayley Nixon, but these were her conditions and she was looking to make a point.
It was very hectic out there today. There were very, very big runs.
This was a paddling race, the best surf ski paddling conditions you can have in the world.
There's some big runners out there, and caught a screamer on the way back, and just had a lot of fun out there today.
McGregor showing his class as he dominates from the get-go, and he was just playing in these conditions. Meanwhile, Nixon and Byrne were going stroke for stroke. Nixon very strong, but Byrne is a master of these conditions, and wasn't giving up that easily. Michelle Byrne proving that experience counts in these conditions. She takes the first win of the series. The ladies now have three winners from four races, and the title is anyone's for the taking. The ladies' series has been one of the most competitive in recent years, with the depth of women's paddling in KZN growing substantially and the level of competition at an all-time high.
The Marine Series is one of the Durban series that have been running as long as I've been paddling. I managed to witness, obviously, the ladies' growth in the series. Initially, when we started, there was maybe a handful of other ladies, and every year there's been a growth in the ladies' field. It's not only the competitive ladies in the last couple of years that I've seen the growth, it's the more recreational paddlers as well, which I think is really good because that's how the sport's going to grow. The ladies seems to be quite a ding-dong battle, which is really exciting because it shows the depth of ladies paddling, and it shows that I mean, you can't just relax one Friday night because anyone can take it. And it also is very dependent on the conditions. The level of ladies paddling has definitely been amazing this year, and it's so nice to see the likes of Bridget Hartley coming from a sprinting background. She did phenomenally well in the surf ski considering she's not from that background. For Hayley, I know she's come from a very, very competitive rowing background, and it was just a matter of time, you know, until she starts racing at the top. She's finally got there and her hard work's paid off. And I'm very, very glad to have those ladies with us here in Durban because, you know, it gives us a nice benchmark, and hopefully we'll be able to push each other leading up to World Champs, and maybe the Durban ladies will be able to showcase there. It's going to be exciting. Anything can happen.
Well, anything can certainly happen, and we move into race 5. There was an air of nervous tension as all the big names were on the start line.
We've had a great outing tonight at the Eurosteel Surf Ski Challenge, which is race 5 of the F&B Surf Ski Series. We've hit the halfway mark with some amazing fields. The field tonight was top class with some of the best paddlers in the world and huge numbers out here at Marine Surf Lifesaving Club on Huntington Beach. Great turnout, and I'm really stoked to see so many people out enjoying their Friday afternoon on the beach.
Well, with conditions changing every week, it's not just about fitness, but strategy. Hank McGregor talks us through a lap.
When I start the race, obviously I've got to think about a strategy, and on an east course like tonight, you go around the first cairn. You want to try and get in front early because there's a lot of boxing around the first cairn. And then from there, we head up the coast towards North Beach, probably about a K and a half with the wind on your side. You try and milk whatever you can get. And then you know you've got a kilometer section that you're going to go dead into the wind. You want to go hard enough that you get in front and stay in front, but obviously not too hard that you are struggling on the into the wind section. You know, you're just going through the motion, almost just banging all the resistances against you. And then once you turn that top cairn, it's dead downwind. I mean, that's really what surf ski paddling is all about. You're just screaming down some runs. You look at your speed, you're doing sometimes 15 kilometers faster than what you're doing on into the wind. In the back of your mind, you know at the end of the downwind leg, you've got to do that all again. So you don't want to go too hard. You want to conserve, and then hopefully you want to go fast enough that you don't lose out because everyone's trying to go for it. So your mental attitude is you've got to be focused the entire race.
I don't think any of us know who's going to win, and it makes us all nervous and it keeps us all on our toes, and it's really exciting racing for all of us leading into the international season.
We've had some great depth in the ladies racing with a couple of really close races, a couple of new winners, Hayley, the World Series champ from 2016, and then a new entry to the series, Bridget Hartley, comes from a sprinting canoeing background, ended up with winning two races so far in the series as well.
It was a close race the whole way. Bridget was hanging in. I did pull away in the Henwood on the second lap. And coming into the last section of downwind, I sort of thought to myself, will she catch? Because that's how Michelle Byrne caught me last week. But I managed to hold her off and take the win, so I'm super chuffed. I think that's what's been nice about the women's season this year. We don't know who's going to win, and everyone seems to be showing a different set of skills with every race that we get. So I don't think any of us know who's going to win, and it makes us all nervous and it keeps us all on our toes.
In the men's field, Hank McGregor showed his class with an amazing win.
This is our fourth win out of five races, so far I've had a clean sweep. It's a little bit different for me. My mental attitude is focusing on the doozy at the moment, but there's nothing better than coming down on a Friday night and racing against all your friends and on Durban's beachfront. I mean, it's a beautiful thing to do, a great way to start the weekend.
So, at the halfway mark, McGregor continues his unbeaten streak and leads the series. Bowman and Krieger trailing now with lots of work to do if they hope to spoil the party. The ladies' series, wide open, three winners in five races. Nixon now leads Hartley with two other good results in the bag, but five races left, so watch out for Michelle Byrne when the surf is bigger. So just five races left and loads of water till the end. McGregor has almost sealed the deal, but the ladies' series is set to go down to the wire. Join us next time for the conclusion of the 2017 FNB Surf Ski Series as we crown our champions. The 2017 FNB Surf Ski Series is proudly presented by FNB.